At the Georgia State Capitol today, House lawmakers got their first look at a controversial bill that passed the Senate last week. The proposed legislation deals with gender-affirming care for kids. A House committee looked at the measure this afternoon in front of a packed crowd. Fox 5's Tyler Fingert was there. He's live at the State Capitol with what happened. A lot of interest in this, Tyler.
Yeah, Christine, a lot of interest. The legislation would restrict gender-affirming care for children under 18. Democrats are opposed to it, but it passed a House committee today in a party-line vote.
I'm never going to get to everybody that wants to speak.
In a packed hearing room at the Georgia State Capitol Tuesday, lawmakers took up one of the more controversial bills of this legislative session.
If we're protecting kids from...
The bill would limit gender-affirming care for kids.
We don't want anybody to have gender surgeries under the age of 18 years old.
State Senator Cardin Summers sponsored the bill. He testified before the House Public Health Committee as they considered his bill, which passed the Senate in a party-line vote last week. The bill would ban most gender surgeries and hormone replacement therapies for kids under 18. Doctors would still be allowed to prescribe puberty blockers.
The basic crux of this bill is simply to pause and allow people, allow young people to get a little bit more mature before they make a decision that is 100% irreversible.
Despite facing opposition in the committee hearing,
everybody in favor?
It passed 12 to 10. One amendment was approved that gives a child the ability to sue if they later regret the procedure banned with this bill. The vote upset transgender advocates and those who have already transitioned.
This bill would not protect children. It will do the opposite.
Leonardo Hennett is 18 and transitioned as a child. Opponents of the bill say it violates equal protection and overrides the decisions of doctors and parents.
Healthcare decisions for my daughter should be between my husband and myself, her legal guardians, and our entire medical team. This bill would deny my daughter access to medical treatments like hormone replacement therapy that have been developed to help her, not harm her.
More than 50 people signed up to speak for and against the bill, but not everyone got the opportunity to do so because of time constraints. The bill now heads to the Rules Committee and then the full House for consideration. But because there was an amendment, it will then be sent back to the Senate if it keeps getting approved, and then eventually the governor's desk. We're live at the State Capitol this afternoon. Tyler Fingert, Fox 5 News.
All right, Tyler, thanks for bringing us the latest from the Capitol today.